Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone slept well last night. I'm up early on my off day. I've already wished my baby brother a happy birthday. I think he turned 48 today. Anyways, I'm up. I got a book in my hand. I want to read this chapter that says, Never and Ever. But before then, I'd like to have a prayer. Father God, in your precious name, Lord Jesus, I pray for a beautiful day for all of us, and I pray that you pour out your blessings upon all of us so that we may be a blessing to others. Thank you for waking us up this morning, and thank you for protecting us throughout our day. I ask you to straighten out the path for us, Lord Jesus, and to bless us as we go to and fro today. In your precious name, Lord Jesus, bless this reading. Amen. Never again. Never and always, I'm sorry. Surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Matthew 28:20. When people teach classes on effective communication, they often advise students to avoid the words never and always. That's because accusing someone of never doing something or of always being a certain way is rarely accurate. A person may exhibit behaviors or have bad habits most of the time, even 99% of the time, but not always or never. For example, you have heard people arguing and one person accuses the other one of never doing their fair share of the work on something. The one accused usually comes back and says, that's not true. The words always and never do not leave room for any expectations, and using them causes us to exaggerate or misrepresent the truth. That's why communication experts say these words have no place in healthy conversations. Always and never. Negative. Negative words. God is the only one who can accurately say never and always. His word is absolute truth. And if he says these words, we can count on them. For example, the Bible says, the Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. Deuteronomy 31:8. God's word also includes Jesus' promise to remain with us always in Matthew 28:20. Our verse for today. The devil often plants thoughts in our minds based on never and always because he knows they can entrap us. He tells us the negative aspects of our lives will never change and will always be the way they are right now. Perhaps he has told you lies such as, all the women in your family are overweight. You will never be slim and trim. Or you don't have the personality to advance at work. You will always be stuck in the job you have today. Or you will always have to deal with the impact of the abuse in your life. You just can't get over that. These type of thoughts can paralyze you by putting fear in your heart. So what I'm saying, don't believe those negative thoughts, because it's the lie from the devil. It is not of the Holy Spirit. It is not of God. It's not of Jesus, okay? These types of thoughts can paralyze you by putting fear in your heart. They can cause you to give up on your dreams and not even try to pursue God's plan for your life. That's exactly why the enemy gives them to you. The devil is a liar. Sooner or later, most things... Pardon me. The devil is a liar. Sooner or later, most things change. Negative situations rarely last forever. So our job is to push through them with prayer, patience, and God's help. As we continue to walk in faith, believe God and trust Him to lead us, we can come out of any negative circumstance in which we find ourselves. So any negative circumstances we may be in, we can come out of it with a whole lot of positive. But you have to have faith, and you have to train your brain to think and believe differently. Don't let the enemy ensnare you with thoughts of never and always. Believe God to change what may seem or feel like it will never change for you. Because the only never and always that mean anything are the ones in His Word. I'm going to read this one again. Don't let the enemy ensnare you with thoughts of never and always. Believe God to change what may seem or feel like it will never change for you. Because the only never and always that mean anything are the ones in His Word. Declare this: I am thankful that God never leaves me and that I always have hope in Him. Yep. Hope in the good Lord. Cheers. Coffee time with Kimmy. So, I'm not at home. I'm over at a friend's house. And I felt led to get up and to do this study. Or reading, should I say. So here I am. And Rose the dog is beside me behind this chair. She's a Rottweiler. Rose. Rosie. What are you doing, girl? I'll get up and show you her. Rose. Come here, Rose. Here she is. Say hi to Rose. This is Rose. This is Rose. Rose, where are you going, baby? There's Rose. See her? Okay, go lay down. Go lay down, big girl. Go lay down. Go lay down. Not by my feet. Anyways, I'm going to end this video. I was going to read some more, but I got this big dog behind me or in front of me. So, that's what I'm going to do. Anyways, love you guys. Talk to you later.